especially first base there, Campos.
I know. There's no way. Anything coming from third base is not a big possible to see. First innings are
brutal. But I think that's pretty astute, knowing I think that it's basically just going to be the first inning, maybe part of the second, and then it'll be gone the rest of the way. That'll definitely be there for the first pitch. Ever here when they played at Guy Mason?
Oh yeah.
How was that feel?
I didn't mind it.
Okay.
Other than foul balls taking out calls on Wisconsin. any foul ball going down first baseline, third baseline, was gonna, you know, the shot was 50-50, was gonna take out a windshield.
Really? Oh my god.
But I liked it. It was small, it was intimate. Uh-huh. It was kind of dug down in.
Oh.
So on the third base side, you had this hill, which was great. You could sit up on it and watch.
Yeah.
There was a parking lot in the outfield, which was too far back for bars to get
to.
Oh,
nice.
It had the Whole Foods on the first base side.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Huh. All right. How far away from here is that?
It's right by the cathedral.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, so it's, okay. All right.
So straight up Wisconsin from campus.
Yeah, so not too far from AU, too.
No,
yeah.
Not far at all.
Yeah, okay. Probably a little bit farther to get over here, huh? Than over there? Yeah.
I liked it. The problem was it was a city park, and so the field was a mess.
Yeah.
Like, when they started practicing, after practices, we were getting the field ready to play.
Whereas here it's already made up for you, right?
Yeah.
So I guess you're sacrificing field preparation time with driving time.
Yeah, and you've got an indoor padding cage here, which
yeah,
you didn't have over there.
And yeah, nice facility.
Yeah. But same thing, I mean, there was some power over there, but there's still no internet. We weren't streaming back then.
Yeah.
Nobody was streaming back then.
Right. Yeah, it sets up a really nice opportunity for that. I'm sure they were probably all crammed in then behind home plate and everything, right? Just to try and, unless there was enough space to be for scores taken.
There was surprisingly room back there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice. Nice. That kind of it right there?
Yeah, that's it.
Can I see that? Okay.
Yep.
That is an interesting...
Oh, you know what? They built that little... That is not... Wasn't there before. No.
Oh,
that.
This.
That
okay.
Wasn't there before.
So, you guys are kind of all lined up.
So, yeah. There was, like, they put a tent back there. That looks like it's a very permanent structure.
5 years ago, it says. So, that must have just...
It must have gone in as soon as they moved here.
Yeah.
Towson, you have 1 minute to take the field.
Interesting. Okay, that's not, it doesn't look bad, I guess.
It's not terrible.
Yeah. But yeah, I guess the public park thing is okay, I see what you're saying with the foul balls, too. Yeah. This feels real good, yeah.
No, it's literally right on Wisconsin.
That's insane.
But it was easy to get to from campus,
right?
Which was nice.
Yeah, I mean, what, you just take that back route, right? Or
yeah, basically go up 35th or whatever,
Kind
of one,
yeah,
and it puts you right there.
That's definitely nice. Did they ever have a field on campus, or has it always been off campus?
When they first started, they actually played at GW. Well, they played up on the softball field at GW, which is at the Potomac.
Yeah,
place right off of Foxhall?
Yes.
That's where they played, I think, a year or two.
Okay.
Then I think they went to Guy Mason. And then after anthem?
Yeah, I usually go after. Yeah.
I can't wait till it gets just a little more when it goes under shade.
Yeah. I can imagine. That's, it's pretty bright. Like perfect to get white balance off of, right?
Yeah, but right now the umpire's like literally silhouetted in the background.
Leading off in center field, number 77, Brianna Ramirez. Batting second at second base, number 6, Corey Jones. Batting third at shortstop, number 24, Mackenzie Link. Batting cleanup, designated player, number 21, Madison Peters. Batting fifth, catcher, number 18, Eddie Ferguson. Batting sixth in right field, number 15, Kara Bonner. Batting seventh at first base, number 9, Kristen Tolan. Batting eighth at third base, number 5, Allie Hickman. Batting ninth in left field, number 23, Kelly Zorb. Pitching for the Tigers, number 25, Morgan Wagner. Towson head coach is Lisa Costello. Assistant coaches are Jesse Mack, Casey Dixon, and Chris Downs. Here's the starting lineup for your Georgetown Hoyas. Leading off in left field, number 10, Cameron Condo. Batting
Welcome in, everybody, to the Washington Nationals Youth Baseball Academy here in Washington, D.C. for some Wednesday night softball action. Soon to be under the lights, or right now under a glaring sun, but a gorgeous night here in our nation's capital. It's the Georgetown Hoyas and the Towson Tigers. Glad you're with us here on Hoya Vision. I'm Christian Taylor. Georgetown coming in off of a loss in the final day, the final game of the series against the Creighton Blue Jays, and honestly, they won the series really nicely against those Blue Jays. Made some heroics, some grand slams, some homers, everything you could imagine, and some good pitching. Towson on the other end, they're coming off of a really nice series against North Carolina A&T, the Aggies, where they took all three, and they're trying to continue a really nice stand against the Georgetown Hoyas. But we get going here just a few minutes early. Brianna Ramirez, the center fielder for the Towson Tigers, will get set and ready to go against Kayla Dunn, the starting pitcher for Georgetown. And away we go as the first pitch is elevated for ball one. Kayla Dunn got the start in the final game against the Creighton Blue Jays and actually had a no-hitter going through three innings, but a lot of walk, a lot of singles. The first couple of batters for the fourth inning came about and she was taken out of the game by Coach Conlin. Julia Parker came in and then all the runs started scoring really for both of the two teams, and it got really crazy there towards the end, didn't it? But Creighton ended up winning the final game there, and Georgetown, they were unable to get the sweep as that one is fouled away. And they'll continue here. Well, for Towson, they also had some late heroics. That North Carolina A&T game, a 3-2 victory in that final game. You know, they got a couple of runs there in the bottom of the sixth inning. The Aggies made it very interesting there in the seventh, scoring one of their own, but it was Towson who ended up prevailing in the end. Maddie Gardner picked up her 10th win of the season. She's not starting today. It is Morgan Wagner, but we'll talk a little bit more about her as she gets back out there. But this is a Towson team who has been finding different ways to win, and wow, what a nice run they've been on here. Six-game win streak. It's another one that's fouled away, and some of them by pretty impressive margins. We're talking about a 12-5 against Hofstra, 15-7 at UMBC, 5-1, 9-2, North Carolina A&T. So some really impressive wins, and of course sitting atop, near the top of the Colonial under head coach Lisa Costello, a legend of the game. 28 seasons for her. I'll tell you what, you can just watch in her, in the way that she talks about this team and talks to her players, that she just loves this program, and this program loves her back. Lots of success has been brought. Still a 1-2 count, by the way, to Ramirez. She finally gets a hold of this one. Zamora has to hustle, and she gets the out. First one of the game. Kayla Dunn really had to work there inside the circle. Corey Jones, the second baseman, now up for Towson, as we will run through their lineups. Mackenzie Lake, she's batting third at short. She is on deck. Madison Peters, the designated player, batting fourth in the hole. Addie Ferguson, fifth there at catcher. Sixth is Kara Bonner in right field. Here's the delivery from Dunn. Hits in for a strike. Kristen Tolan, the first baseman, batting seventh. Allie Hickman at third base, batting eighth. And Kelly Zorb, the left fielder, batting ninth, with, again, Morgan Wagner as the starting pitcher today. Dunn takes another hurl at this one, and it's very quickly 0-2 to Corey Jones, the junior from Morrisville, PA. Transferred in from Hartford, has been a Towson Tiger now for her second year. Next delivery just misses the strike zone. It'll stay one ball and two strikes here. Corey Jones batting 323, which is certainly as good as it's gotten here in her career. Had some good moments last year, but has just really extended and is savoring this number two spot in the lineup. And that one is called strike three. Unbelievable placement by Kayla Dunn. And that's two away. And sets up Mackenzie Lake
The fast Mackenzie Lake. The powerful Mackenzie Lake. Has turned into the massive leader for this team. 4.08 average. Somebody else who has just continued to keep going. Named the all rookie team in the Colonial back in 2021. Just hasn't missed a single beat. And you'll be able to see it just in the way that she carries herself. Curves away from her. One ball, one strike. And Kayla Dunn looking to get out of this inning. This very difficult top of the Towson order. 1-2-3. It's a Towson team who are 23-17 this year. 12-6 in Colonial play. This one a little blooper at second, and basket catch for Casey Lyman, and it closes off the first inning. 1-2-3. We will head on up to the bottom of the first inning. Zero score. Let's see what the Hoyas can do with their first look offensively. Cam Kondo, who is playing as well as just about anybody right now, set up here in the right-handed batter's box. And it is good to see her back out there. As we got the windup and the pitch from Wagner, her first delivery is in for strike one. Now, the reason we say that, folks, is towards the end of that Creighton game on Sunday, she had the play. It was Kaylee Wilson who hit just a bomb into left center field, and Cam Kondo chased it down all the way. This one elevates a little bit. One ball, one strike. She chased it down, got her glove to it just as the ball was passing over the fence, and it ended up as a homer, which gave Creighton the lead. And she banged into that fence really hard and was slow to get up. Two balls and one strike. And she stayed down for quite a bit. I mean, we can talk almost 60 seconds or at least a little bit more, but she got back up but wasn't looking 100%. And including chasing down a couple of those fly balls, was always holding the rib area, but she's back out there, looks pretty close to 100% again. It's 3-1. Takes her trademark long stride out of the batter's box here. But the reason why we say she's been playing so well and maybe just about as good as anybody is these home runs. I mean, we're talking about a walk-off homer against Creighton on Friday. It's taken deep in the eighth inning as there's ball four to Cam Kondo. We'll take a leadoff walk, something that's also been happening a little bit here too recently. But we were talking about four straight games where Cam Kondo had clobbered a homer and nothing could be stopped, really. Even the outs that she was taking were reaching the warning track. But opposing pitchers have just been really trying to slow her down. This one laid low by Zamora. There's the turnaround, and she gets the out at first, but the sacrifice bunt is successful. So I beg your pardon, it was three straight games for Kondo where she had a homer, but four home runs in three games for Kondo. Couple home runs for her against Creighton in that first game. And now it's May Forshee, so different role for her today, playing the role of designated player. First strike there. We'll go through the rest of their lineup here. Kayla Dunn is on deck pitching. Lorena Vasquez and Zunza at third base batting fifth. Samantha Miller's behind the plate batting sixth. Naya Campos at first base seventh. Gianna Shulo in right batting eighth. And Claire Turner ninth in center. And it's low again. You see Coach Conlon just making a couple little tweaks from the usual lineup for this Wednesday evening game. She's liked what Samantha Miller's brought. She's liked what Gianna Shulo has brought. So might as well reward them with a little bit of playing time as this one's chopped up the middle by Forshee. Quickly reacting to it is Morgan Wagner. And it's another ground out to the pitcher. But Cam Kondo now standing at third base. And it's Kayla Dunn who is going to need to try and help her own cause here. Always a fascinating concept when you can have the pitcher try and help her own situation. Something that doesn't really happen in baseball too much anymore. There's a strike. Of course, in Major League Baseball with the DH rule being universal. And college ball, it's always kind of been like that as well. But in softball, oh, the pitcher can do whatever she wants. She can bat if she needs to, and speaking of which, hits one far and deep, and it will score Kondo, and Kayla Dunn rounding first, looking to get to second, she does. Two out RBI double, Georgetown lead 1-0. And this is what Georgetown have been doing a little bit better job of as of recent, has been playing the small ball where they've been moving runners around and then getting the clutch hit to get them in. That's exactly what's happened on this round. Kondo got on. She got herself to third after a couple of ground outs, and Kayla Dunn stepping in, giving herself a little bit of run support. Lorena Vasquez and Zunza, the batter here, the third baseman. 0-1 count. Wind up and the pitch. Right down the heart of the plate. Strike two. Vasquez and Zunza batting 225 this year. Has played in every game. Only her and May Forshee have been given that distinction this season. Here's the next delivery. Another one ripped up the middle. It is through for a base hit, and the green light is on for Dunn, and she scores. Lorena Vasquez and Zunza, RBI single. Hoyas lead 2-0. It's the type of offense you want to see. You get two runners in scoring position, they both make their way home. For Lorena Vasquez and Zunza, folks, that is her 13th RBI of the season. Her first since the 3-RBI game in the final game against the Providence Friars on April 6th. You know, it's just crazy to think that all of a sudden we're like 10 days away from ending the month of April. How quickly this month has gone. The 1-0. Another one that's ripped right side. Another base hit. Three straight for the Hoyas. And Samantha Miller has one now. Her ninth hit of the season. Morgan Wagner's getting hit here with a couple of outs. And Naya Campos, who is also in a decent run right now, will get a crack with two runners on. The reason why we say she's on right now, well, gotta remember that home run that she just hit. Hit a home run in the first game of two against the Creighton Blue Jays in their mercy rule game. One ball, no strikes here. And she's been seeing the ball relatively well, even though that is her only hit this month. Just seems like it's coming a little bit harder off of her bat. And it was just a massive confidence boost for her seeing that one go over the fence. It's actually pretty close to us, too, out here. One-one count to Campos. Takes a big hack at that one. And thuds off the side of the clubhouse here at the Nationals Youth Baseball Academy. Naya Campos, the young freshman out of Tucson, Arizona. Always see lots of Arizona representation. And Towson's no different. They do have Madison Peters, who's from Arizona. This one could be a little blooper into right, or beg your pardon, into left, but it is grabbed by Kelly Zorb, and that closes off the first inning. And Georgetown tally, two runs on three hits. We go to the second. 2-0 for the Hoyas.
This half inning might do it, depending how long it goes, yeah. I like it. I like how that team got the hits where they needed it. They just moved her around, got what they needed to. That was good.
So it's 4-5-6 for Towson. Madison Peters, Addie Ferguson, Kara Bonner. As Towson tries to respond, now as they're trailing 2-0. Well, it's another two-run inning for Georgetown to start off this game. This is the third straight game they've had two runs in the first inning. You could almost extend that to four, because Creighton in game one on Friday had two runs in the first inning, so four straight games where there have been a couple of runs plated by any team that Georgetown has either been a part of or played against. It's an 0-2 count on Peters here. The DP. Wide up in the pitch from Dunn, fouled away. Still get a little bit of the sun here. It's now only Gianna Shulo, if she tracks her way to her left side, that has any bit of sun left. We've still got it here in the outfield, but Claire Turner doesn't have it where she's at now. It's ducked below from her vantage point. The 0-2. This one absolutely ripped, but well foul. Just as a few cars pass in below us here. 0-2. Madison Peters, we just mentioned, one of the Arizona natives. Chandler, Arizona. The only one on this Towson team. Even though there are a few on the Georgetown end of things. May Forshee from Phoenix, Arizona. Sophia Scarangella from Tucson, Arizona. Naya Campos, we mentioned, from Tucson as well. Lorena Vasquez and Zunza from Chandler, Arizona. They did not go to the same high school, by the way, Peters and LVI, as there's a swing and a miss. They're the first out of the inning, second strike out of the game for Kayla Dunn. LVI went to Hamilton High School, and Madison Peters went to Basha High School. So they might have played each other. Addie Ferguson, the catcher. And we will roll through the defense for Georgetown here. Of course, in the circle is Kayla Dunn. Behind the plate, Samantha Miller. First delivery on the way. Extends out of the strike zone. Naya Campos at first. Casey Lyman at second. Lorena Vasquez and Zunza at third. Morgan Zamora at short. Cam Kondo left. Claire Turner center. Gianna Shulo in right. Big hack for strike two. Addie Ferguson, the catcher. Freshman from Valencia, California. He just always got to love the freshmen who step right in and immediately make a difference. She's batting 303, playing in just her 16th game this year. That was lost out of the hands of Dunn. And a lot of her action has come very recently, actually. I mean, at the start of the year, she got a couple of looks. Her first collegiate hit was against Charleston Southern, the Buccaneers, back on February 25th. And then only played a few games in the month of March, just four total. Was kind of in and out of the lineup. There's another big swing, that's strike two. But then come the month of April. Five straight games where she recorded a hit. George Mason, a couple Hofstra, UMBC, and the start of the North Carolina A&T series, including going 2-for-2 in the final game against the Aggies very recently, their most recent game. So another ball to the count here. It is full to Addie Ferguson. Wind up, pitch, big swing and a miss. And Ferguson is down on strikes. Kayla Dunn with three from her right hand. For Addie Ferguson, that is her 15th strikeout of the season. Kara Bonner, the right fielder now. Another freshman, Danville, PA. That ball hustles in towards Miller, and it's a ball. Bonner batting 296. It's a little more longer of a campaign than the other freshman who just struck out, Addie Ferguson. Just shows you how Coach Costello can just bring in the new players. They make the impacts immediately. Or they stick around and continue to grow, like a few examples we have today. Brianna Ramirez being one of those, perfect example of that. The 1-1 popped away and up into the elevated picnic tables. 1-2. By the way, folks, during the weekend, we had a Creighton fan up there. And he snagged one of those foul balls, like jumped up for it one-handed, brought it down very nonchalantly. Was extremely impressive. Fortunately, there aren't quite as many Towson fans up there today as there were Creighton over the weekend. It was a Creighton-filled weekend, really, with their baseball team making their way over, too, from Omaha, Nebraska. Lots of different shades of blue here in this venue that weekend. The 2-2. This one's deep. Left center, Cam Kondo right in front of it, and she got to it. And that closes off the second inning for Georgetown. Well, Kayla Dunn goes 1-2-3 here for these couple of innings, and we'll see what the home half brings again. Hoyas Towson after this. Well, here we go. Home half of the second inning as Morgan Wagner takes one home to start it off against Gianna Shulo, the right fielder. Glad you're with us here tonight. I'm Christian Taylor on Hoya Vision. A rare under the lights game here at the Washington Nationals Youth Baseball Academy. Wagner takes the next one, and Shulo up the middle. No doubt about it. And she's in with a leadoff single. Claire Turner, with her trademark walk-up song, California Knows How to Party. And she is a California girl. Palo Alto. Wow, has she just been fun to watch this year. It's that speed she has that is just so hard to look away from. Honestly, my opinion, is a perfect spot for this nine hole just to lead into Kondo. And thinking about going with Shulo, you know, she does have a little bit of pace over there. Shulo has been used multiple times this season as a pinch runner. Doesn't have any stolen bases, but she has helped give Georgetown some runs this year. She has 7 to be exact. Elevates a little bit there. Two to zero the score. Georgetown leading, bottom two, Wagner. And hang on a moment. It's a loose softball, and I think that came from the Georgetown pen. I got Avery Wismar, who just tossed that one. She's got her hands in her face right now. Yep, that's exactly where it came. Here's the next delivery. Going is Shulo. The hit and run is on. It bounces off of Wagner and into first goes Turner. And watch out, it was tossed away. Shulo gets into third. It wasn't tossed away by much, but it was enough for Shulo to take advantage and waltz on into a better position for Cam Kondo. This is another hit. 5 hits for Georgetown batting today, 4 of them singles. Watch out, there she goes again. Turner in a second, and it's into center field. And the risk paid off, and Turner goes into third while Shulo scores. They played the role of dummy just to see if Ferguson would take the bait. And Turner did it, got it successfully into second, and by the time it got away, Shulo had already crossed home plate. So it is now 3-0 for Georgetown. Now, even when Kondo's not getting a hit, she's still doing damage. And so for Shulo, that is her 8th run of the season. That's just heads-up base running by both Turner and Shulo. That's why they're there in this bottom of the lineup. It's just create chaos like that. As play will resume here just after the very brief meeting, probably just to settle some things down there. Here it comes, it's low, and a swing and a miss by Kondo. Strike two. Here it comes, ripped into right field, base hit. Scoring is Turner, and an RBI single for Cam Kondo, 4-0 for Georgetown. Three straight string singles for this Georgetown offense, and talk about 5 of their last 6 batters all the reach on just a one bagger. And Morgan Zamora stepping in. Wagner takes this pitch. Kondo is stealing. Throw to second. Oh, they got her. Oh, no. The ball was dropped. And Kondo safely into second. The throw certainly beat her, but the turnaround tag was not. And so Kondo with her fifth successful stolen base this season. And you see already, this is a team that doesn't steal too much, Georgetown. They're just 20 of 28 coming in, but they sense that they can try and test Ferguson here tonight. Oh, and two. Already stealing a lot more than what they have in recent memory. Wagner needs a good one here at 0-2. Zamora makes contact, left side for Jones, slides into it, and just gets the play by a half a step. That's a speedy Zamora. 4-3 put out. Runner in Kondo advances to third. This is Forshee, and bounces in the dirt, and Kondo takes advantage. A wild pitch, able to score Kondo. And it's 5-0 for Georgetown. Shulo, Turner, Kondo, the first three batters of this inning, they all came across. Consistent and smart base running by the Hoyas, but now the bags are empty as a strike's given to May Forshee here. May Forshee, who just grounded back to Wagner in the first inning. Playing role is DP here. This next delivery is through, ripped right at Jones. Just had to extend the glove. Two away. She has recorded both outs of this inning. Kayla Dunn, the only extra base hit for the Hoyas today, has been off the bat of Kayla Dunn. Everything else has been singles. Of their six hits, five of them, just one base. Check swing, and it's foul. We'll run through that defense of Towson here with Ferguson behind the plate, Kristen Toland at first. Corey Jones at second, Mackenzie Lake short, Allie Hickman at third, Kelly Zorbin left, Brianna Ramirez center, and Kara Bonner in right. One and one. Two outs in the bottom of the second inning. Five runs have crossed for the Hoyas. Wagner looking to get out of this here. And there's nobody warming up right now for Towson. Figuring that this might be Wagner's game, at least for the meantime. She is just appearing in her 12th game this season, but her 8th start. Drops down for a 3-1. ERA of 6.48. Does have a complete game this year. It was a mercy rule game where she got that one. The 3-1, chopper up the middle. Jones diving out, and it's back in to center field. Done with a double and a single. Let's see if Coach Conlin throws out a pinch runner for Dunn over there. Well, Dunn can move, but we'll just see if she wants to get another runner in scoring position, and it looks like that might be what's happening. As Lorena Vasquez and Zunza steps in, and she is immediately pointing to one of her Georgetown players in that dugout. And it looks to be Brittany Liu, who was opted against the starting role today. She's usually the right fielder for Georgetown. Instead, it's Gianna Shulo today. But we figured we'd see her at least once. It's going to be right in for this pinch run situation. Brittany Liu with no stolen bases this season. We're going to see if Coach Collin wants to try and do the same here and test Ferguson one more time behind the plate. First delivery, ripped foul. Liu, the senior from Potomac, Maryland, just changed her number from 3 to 23 in the offseason. Pitch comes from Wagner, skied high, center field, backing up Ramirez. She gets it as she clanks into the center field wall. And Lorena Vasquez and Zunza just inches shy of what would have been her second home run of the season. But the inning is over. 3 cross for the Hoyas, 5 zip heading into the third. Well, we got a defensive replacement here for the Hoyas. Kiaris Alvarado Rojas replaces Naya Campos over there at first base. And so it's Kristen Toland, the other first baseman in today's game, who has stepped in here and at strike one. So both Georgetown baseball and softball have made this, you know, Washington Nationals Youth Baseball Academy their home facility. Of course, softball's had it here for a while. Last year, you could really call the Georgetown Hoyas the Georgetown Rovers for all the different places they were playing. Played over in Bowie, played over in Crofton or Waldorf, really, and played over here at the Baseball Academy, played over in Bethesda, anywhere you could imagine. But Coach Thompson wanted to make this place their home this year, and so it sets up for some awesome little doubleheaders, if you will, as there's a swing and a miss from Tolan for strike two, to where you can get softball and baseball going on at the same time. So if one ends, you can pop on over to the other. And that's going on tonight. Obviously, Towson coming here for softball, but another Maryland team, Mount St. Mary's, have made their way down for the Georgetown baseball side, and there's a swing and a miss for Krista Toland. That's the fourth strikeout for Kayla Dunn tonight. Mount St. Mary's, by the way, folks, just got a brand new coach last year, and they weren't 100% ideal, but this year, oh, they've made some major steps, kind of like, you know, year one to two with Coach Thompson. Year one, he was trying to figure out who all fit where, and it was a very weird COVID year. And it was a Georgetown baseball team that didn't win much. And then last year, they just go in and they pursue chances of the postseason. They got in the Big East tournament, obviously didn't go too much further than that, but what a step that team made. Well, it's Mount St. Mary's who are playing Georgetown here tonight, and even though they have made some major steps, they're getting walloped by the Hoyas right now. And that's kind of an understatement. As we talk, Mount St. Mary's just scored their first run of the game. The score is 16-1, bottom of the fifth inning. So that is what's going on over there. And it's Georgetown softball who are winning nicely at the moment, 5-0 here. Just found out, too, that baseball is a really weird mercy rule on Sundays. And the game was a lot closer than what this one is tonight here on this Wednesday evening. Outside again, two balls, two strikes from Kayla Dunn. It is Allie Hickman at the plate, the third baseman. Junior, Rock Hall, Maryland, out of Kent County High School. Has played in all but four this season. Hickman awaits the next one, has to buckle her knees away. And the count is now 3-2 to Hickman. And Towson trying to get their first base runner of the game. The Allie Hickman chant starting from the Towson dugout. Here it comes, got a piece of it. Does it roll fair? No, it doesn't. See, Kiaris Alvarado Rojas was waiting for it. The disadvantage of turf, where usually if it has a little bit of spin on it, it needs to be crazy spin to roll back in or out. If you got that grass there, you can use a little bit of help there to move it on in. There's some contact, right side foul territory, and it's out of the range. Watch out. A couple of innocent fans walking on that sidewalk over there. But didn't hit them, fortunately. Gotta be alert at all times in this venue. Hickman batting 260 this season. Just hit her first homer of the season against Hofstra. This one swung on and missed. Dunn is dealing at the moment. Five strikeouts. And it's Kelly Zorb. This is the final batter for the Towson Tigers. You know, it's been incredible by Kayla Dunn inside the circle. You know, she didn't get her first pitching appearance of the season until March. Nothing going on there in the month of February. Now, granted, I mean, you don't play too many games in February, but they did start relatively early. And we're talking at least double-digit games before the start of March. Dunn winds up and takes this one, ripped into left. Kondo chasing, its foul. You'd have to think at least a thought or two crossed through Kondo's mind about leaping out for it. But didn't want to risk that one for sure. But Kayla Dunn started throwing some appearances. Southeastern Louisiana, Middle Tennessee, Holy Cross. And kind of consistently started getting the looks come conference play. Villanova, she appeared in all three. Had to play role of settler in some of those games. There's that one mercy rule game against Villanova where things just really got out of hand. There's that 16-2 game where she had to come in and just get Georgetown out of the game. The 2-1 slapped left side. It looks pretty good, but it's foul again. Got three players converging for it, but fell down foul. And so Kelly Zorb, who has already made a couple of deep runs around first base, will need to catch her breath again. Towson, a team, has got a couple of nice slap hitters. Brianna Ramirez, another one of those. It's always dangerous to have. It's an aspect of this sport that you can never overlook. A lot of the good teams will have players who can do that effectively. And there she is trying it again, but Kondo is playing shallow. And yet again, a 1-2-3 inning for Kayla Dunn in the circle. Bottom part of the third inning awaits us after this. It's going to be 6-7-8 for Georgetown here in this inning. Samantha Miller, Naya Campos, Gianna Shulo. Where they're already leading 5-0. Kayla Dunn has pitched a masterclass so far. Three straight 1-2-3 innings, five strikeouts for her. And Samantha Miller, who singled her last time up. Up for her second at-bat of the game. It's a decent shout having Samantha Miller start this game. Just her 13th start of the season, 26th game played. And, you know, May 4th, she's just seen so much action behind the plate. So to throw a Miller in there is definitely a different look. Fouled back and behind our tent. There at the scorer's table back there. 0-2 quickly to Miller. Her last appearance was against Coppin State last Tuesday. That was the perfect game day for Brooke Plonka. A little off speed that she's able to hold off of here. Went 1-for-1 in that game, one of just a few hits. But that was her first hit, Miller. Her first hit since March 3rd against Southeastern Louisiana. And her hit today is just her second hit in that stretch. Lots of 0-for-3s, 0-for-1s in that time. Does it feel like at the moment she's seeing the ball just a little bit better? As Miller awaits the 2-2 pitch. Does make some contact. It is fair. She's got two in this game, and she's going to try for second base. In standing up. Have a game, Samantha Miller. 2-for-2. Kiaris Alvarado Rojas, who was the defensive replacement for Naya Campos. Their first at bat of the day. The leadoff batter has been on in every inning so far for Georgetown. This has been a clinic offensively. 8 hits. And they have benefited off of 2 Towson errors as well. Miller thinking about heading towards third, gets about halfway. Kiaris Alvarado Rojas was one of the main looks for first base, or for a few games at least. For Naya Campos continued her stretch. There's a rocket over at short. Lake takes care of business. 6-3 put out. First out, and it moves Miller to third. Then Alvarado Rojas, she's playing in her 24th game here tonight. Only has a couple of hits on the season. But once again, her most recent hit coming against Coppin State. First hit since February against Norfolk State, February 19th. So she's due, certainly, you'd think. Big swing and a miss from Gianna Shulo, who's just in line for a nice day. You know, this is a great opportunity for both Miller and Shulo, who have stepped in as either a pinch hitter or a pinch runner this season, or even a defensive replacement, but to show Coach Conlon what else they have in the tank. And you can have a good performance against a good team in Towson. That's going to help the cause and, you know, maybe some looks for the upcoming weekend. As they head on up to St. John's. That's a strikeout there for Shulo. Claire Turner to the plate. Singled, scored a run in the second inning. Remember, Georgetown, they are on the road for almost the rest of this season after this game tonight. Strike one there. At St. John's, the 21st, 22nd, and 23rd, followed by a little short trip down to Fairfax, Virginia. George Mason, 3-game series at Butler over in Indianapolis before they end the season here at home against the DePaul Blue Demons. Senior weekend, if you will, but it's a weekend to have circle on your calendar, folks. It's a Georgetown team who are sniffing the postseason for the first time in a while. 1-1, chopper right side, and Jones can't handle. Another one crosses, and Turner back on in to first base. Miller is the recent run scorer. Third error of the game for Towson. That's not going to help causes, that's for sure. 6-0. And now we're kind of in tricky territory with Cam Kondo at the plate. This one a little high. Turner stealing second base again, and it's tossed away again. Turner gets up as it's overthrown yet again. Turner into third for the second straight time. They are testing Ferguson, and they've gotten it every step of the way. Again, folks, this is a team that doesn't steal too many bases, but you think with a game like this, Turner might be stealing more, and she has, at least for Georgetown standpoint, been the leader when it's come to that. Came into this game 11 for 14. She already has picked up a few more now, 13 stolen bases on 16 attempts this year. Another one that's just a tad high. 3-0. Well, the scoreboard reads four errors, but a couple of the listed errors up there are just throwaways there heading into second base. As there's ball four to Kondo. Probably your best case scenario there, too. Runners at first and third. Morgan Zamora with two runners on, two outs in the third. 6-0 for Georgetown against Towson, who have made their way an hour south from Maryland. And Kondo thought about it. There's a quick check at third, just in case. You know, Turner getting really antsy over there. Would love to take another one across home plate. But this is just abnormal for Towson right now. Seeing all these runs going across from them, and nothing's been really going for them offensively. First ball, the count to Morgan Zamora, who has a couple of ground outs today. Sacrifice bunt in the first inning, and then a ground out to Corey Jones at second last inning. Just committed an error moments ago. A run and hit as Jones this time secures that one. And so Morgan Zamora, even though this offense has been rolling, she is 0 for 3 today. Okay, fourth inning upon us here in Washington, D.C. Top of the fourth inning. Brianna Ramirez, the slap hitter. And she tried showing bunt there and stayed around for strike one. Grounded out to shortstop in Morgan Zamora in the first inning. Back when the sun was shining deep into our eyes out here. Just a done. Just had to stretch out that glove. 10 straight batters retired for Dunn. That's Corey Jones. And now there is a little bit of action in that Towson pen. By the way, folks, that sun was out. It was gorgeous out here. It's just now gone, and it has dropped like 10 degrees. It's incredible. But it's still pretty comfortable out here. It's more like a light jacket night now. Corey Jones struck out looking in the first inning. Another chance here. Grounder at second base. Casey Lyman, very quick relay to first. Two away. Warming up for Towson right now is Paige Kostick, the sophomore pitcher from West Lawn, PA. I mean, she can play anywhere, really. I mean, the roster, of course, lists her as outfield, utility, and pitcher. Kostick this season doesn't have an at-bat, though, so she's been usually there inside the circle, but could be the next look. She's only pitched and appeared in seven this season, but has a really nice 2-0 win-loss record. This is Mackenzie Lake. Popped out to second base in the first inning. Lake awaits the next one. Takes a little bit of contact on this. This is going to be some trouble, and it is. And the first base runner is on for Towson, and that is their first hit as well. 11 hitless batters for Kayla Dunn. Trying to pull her best Brooke Planka impersonation. Got pretty close, though. Got about halfway through the game against a very dangerous Towson team. But let's see if this ignites the Tigers' offense. Now Madison Peters at the plate. The powerful Madison Peters. She's got three homers this year. As that one's tossed away by Dunn, and an easy trot in the second for Mackenzie Lake. And now all of a sudden, Towson asking a few questions. Madison Peters, a .359 average. 47 hits this year, which is good for second on the team, behind Mackenzie Lake, the one who's standing over there at second. Just continues to find ways. Figured if anybody was going to do it, it was going to be her. Mackenzie Lake only has six games this season without a hit. So this team needed one. She got it. Now can try and use that speed over at second. A little bit of piece of it from Peters. That's fouled away. One ball and two strikes. It's been the main catcher the last few seasons for this Towson team. But today playing DP. There's a swing and a miss. Strike three. And it is Dunn who gets out of the inning, leaves that runner at second base. We are through three and a half innings here on Hoya Vision. to the heart of the order for Georgetown, but they're going to have to do so against a new pitcher. It is Paige Kostick. As we alluded to her before, sophomore from West Lawn, PA. This is just her eighth appearance this season and her first appearance since March against Elon, where she threw two innings, allowed three hits, four earned runs, and all of her appearances in relief, including this one. So just 15 total innings, and figure this is just a perfect time to get another look, as immediately it is Forshee who takes advantage of a ball in the strike zone, and she singles for the first time tonight. And now it's Kayla Dunn, who is having a whale of a game right now. If you were to put together your player of the game just here in the fourth inning, it would 100% be Kayla Dunn, with her two hits, RBI run score, and one hit allowed in her pitching performance. Forshee, very dangerous over there at first, taking a decent step, a stutter step too. Try and trip up Ferguson over there behind the plate. The last plate appearance for Kayla Dunn, she singled. That was in the second inning. Was pinch run for by Brittany Liu. And a foul ball. The hitting for Kayla Dunn's been pretty solid this season. 280 average. 28 hits now. That's a live tally. And she's been good here in the last few games. Had three hits in the Creighton series. And they were both the final two games. All came on Sunday. Two balls, one strike here. And May Forshee is the runner over at first base. Not a stolen base threat, but, you know, she could try as Dunn clobbers one left center, and it is out of the glove of Ramirez. But because she got so close to it and maybe almost should have had it, Forshee playing it carefully is still just at second base. So runners don't go any much further, but it's another hit for Kayla Dunn, who's 3-for-3 today. That was so close by Ramirez. That's just it, though. That fence has give. And I think for some fielders, as we've seen, at least in this recent week to weekend, it catches you a little off guard. You're expecting a loud thud and to just kind of absorb yourself into that fence, but it gives a little. You have to spring in there and be ready for a bounce back. We saw it with Ella Dalton, the center fielder for Creighton, over the weekend. We saw it with Cam Kondo over the weekend, too. And now we've seen it with Brianna Ramirez at least a couple of times. 10 hits for the Georgetown offense. And yet again, all but two have been singles. 0-2 to LVI. And it misses the strike zone. Single RBI in the first inning. And a fly out to center in the second inning. That was the other one that Ramirez had here in center. Takes a huge rip in the left. It's foul by just a mere inches. Stays at 1-2. And so Dunn's going to have to retreat. Forshee's going to have to retreat. There is another pitcher out there for Towson right now. It's Cheyenne Bion, another freshman from Owings Mills, Maryland, so didn't have to travel too far to go to college in Towson. This one's low, but she got a little bit of contact with it. Lake tossed a second, she got there. And so it's a 6-4 fielder's choice for the first out of the inning. As Forshee moves to third. Samantha Miller. Hey, she's had a good game today, hasn't she? Also 2-for-2. Single in the first, double and a run scored in the third. Outfield moves in just a tad. At least Ramirez does in center. Trying to potentially set up this double play too. And there's a strike to Miller. Junior from Tampa, Florida, by way of the Academy of the Holy Names. She can play infield too, primarily third base, but Lorena Vasquez and Zunza has situated herself there quite a bit this year, so next option for Samantha Miller is catcher. And that's where she is tonight. 6-0 for these Hoyas. This has been a Hoyas team that has turned a little bit of a corner this year, certainly in Big East play, but they're getting some nice results ever since that calendar switched into about mid-March. Oh, and it pops out of the glove of Lake and into left field, and it should have been the second out of the inning. Instead, it's a seventh run for Georgetown. Goodness me. Just these errors not helping causes either. Should potentially be listed here as an E6. So crossing the plate there was Forshey once again. Heads up running. New batter for the Hoyas here. Abby Schiller, who can also play first base, is pinch hitting. We'll see if she stays in as the defensive replacement, but it's a third different batter here in this seventh spot. Naya Campos had the first at bat, then it was K-A-R, Kiaris Alvarado Rojas, and now it is Schiller. So runners are at first and second. LVI at second, Miller at first. Wind up in the pitch. And is another ball here to Schiller. Campos had flown out to left in the first inning. Rojas ground out to short in the third. And now it is Schiller here in the fourth. 3-0 count, too. She's doing the job so far. So the scoreboard reads five errors. However, the official stats on the live stats read two errors. That's what we're going to go off of, even though it hasn't been pretty defense. Those three others that the scoreboard operator here has tallied have been from the tosses into center from Addie Ferguson. Kostick with the next delivery. This will be up the middle, although Lake able to corral it in time. Relay to first, not quite, but yet again, another 6-4 fielder's choice. And gets another runner an inch closer. And another pinch hitter for Georgetown, Gabby Nemrick for Gianna Shulo here. So a couple of quick swaps here. Gianna Shulo was 1-for-2, single and a run scored. And comes in with two runners on. Runner at first, runner at third. A long pause before ball was called by the home plate umpire. Nemrick Jr. from Connecticut attended the Westminster School. She as well has been a pinch hitter, pinch runner, pinch defensive player, if you will, this season. This is an important run here for Georgetown, because if they can get the eighth, that means Towson only have the top of the fifth inning to score one to keep this game going. Nemrick receives a strike. It's eight runs after five is the mercy rule for softball. And that eighth run is standing over at third base. And Lorena Vasquez and Zunza. Delivery through, popped up shallow center field. Chasing it in is Ramirez and keeps this all intact. As the Hoyas do play one more here in the fourth inning. We had an up to the fifth, 7-0. Ferguson. 5-6-7 for Towson here in the fifth inning. Addie Ferguson, Kara Bonner, Kristen Tolan. As Towson trails 7-0, top of the fifth inning. Kayla Dunn pitching wonderfully. A single is all she's given up tonight. And now the lights are really taking full effect here. And it's making me wish we had some more night games here at this facility. This is just gorgeous. A lot of these games are morning games, which again benefits a lot of people. Certainly it's a little bit easier to play in the daytime too. Is this one tracked right side, continuing foul and lands in a tree, but it's certainly a different look under the lights, isn't it? Towson dugout making a little bit of noise here, and they're trying to do so, trying to get some sort of bit of inspiration here, as nobody's really been able to find anything against Kayla Dunn tonight. Addie Ferguson with Kara Bonner on deck, hoping to get on for her. The 1-2, fouled away. Now Towson in just some awesome gold unis tonight. Gold jerseys. A little bit of black piping on the sleeves. White numbers, black outline. Got Towson written across the chest in white, outlined in black. Gray pants. One black stripe across the leg, as there is a swing and a miss from Ferguson, who looks visibly frustrated after that one. Her second strikeout of the day. Seventh for Dunn. Kara Bonner, the next batter. Socks pulled up for Towson are in black. Georgetown wearing their black unis tonight. There is something about Georgetown sports and black unis that just works. Have that black and gray going, and maybe just a little bit of a sense of navy involved. It's close to a perfect uniform. Gray numbers on the back outlined in white. Gray striping both on the jerseys and the shorts, as well as a gray belt for these Georgetown players. This one is towered high, center field. However, it is right field in Gabby Nemrick, who's able to call off the center fielder in Turner. That's two outs. So Nemrick, of course, has stayed in in replacement of Gianna Shulo, so her day is done. Kristen Toland struck out swinging in the third. Dunn looking for yet another 1-2-3 inning. It's only the last inning, the fourth inning, where that has not happened for her. She got the two outs. Mackenzie Lake with a single that didn't exit the out, or exit the infield rather, and just sprinted her way on, got to second base off of a wild pitch, but that was it. Strike two. Just for comparison this season, just to show you how insane of a game this has been so far by Dunn as she sits and waits here. Swing and a miss for strike three. Well, I will discuss that in the bottom of the fifth inning. We'll pause for a moment. Eight strikeouts for Kayla Dunn. Back after this on Hoya Vision. Well, that music only means one thing. It's Sophia Scarangella pinch hitting. This is significant in this reason. On Sunday, folks, the conclusion of game two of this series, Georgetown led 5-1. She hit a grand slam to walk it off and end the night. Georgetown just need 1-1 to make it 8-0 and end the evening. Eight-run mercy rule here in the fifth. And so Coach Conlin has hoped for the same here as she is pinch hitting for Claire Turner. Now, what I was about to say before the end of that inning is Towson have only been shut out four times this season. Show you how good this offense has been this year. And right now, just only one hit off the pitching of Kayla Dunn. And that could be it tonight if Georgetown just plate one here in the fifth inning. Scarangella waits for this one. It's foul ball. Morgan Wagner started off the night for the Tigers as she made it through three, but by then the damage was close to done. Literally, Kayla Dunn. Six runs through three innings. They got one more in the fourth off of Paige Kostick here. This one right back to Kostick, and there's the first out. So there will be no ending of the night by Scarangella here in the fifth inning. Here's Cam Kondo. Oh, beg your pardon. I have a pinch hitter here for Georgetown. First delivery in by Kostick, and that is a strike. Gabby Park is the pinch hitter for the Hoyas. Gabby Park playing in her 20th game this season as time is called here. Gabby Park, the freshman from Franklin Lakes, New Jersey. Her first game since the Providence series, she went 1-for-2. This pinch hitting for Kondo here, rips one at second, and easy for Jones, two down. Morgan Zamora has stayed in here as the infield will now go out and greet Kostick here and chat with her, just as Coach Elvina is having some words with Morgan Zamora here. She's really the only Georgetown starter who was still in, who has not gotten a hit tonight, has not left the infield. Pop up to second in the third, ground out to second in the second, and a sacrifice bunt that rolled back to Morgan Wagner in the first inning. That was the more urgent for a hit here tonight to add on to this. She had some heroics there in that late frame against Creighton over the weekend. The ball sent to right field. We talked about the Ella Dalton colliding into the fence here for Creighton. She's the one who hit the ball and tied up the game heroically at the time before the Hoyas allowed some runs there in the top half of the final inning to eventually lose the game. The 1-1. Zamora takes another ball. 2-1. Zamora, of course, transferred in from California, where she played 46 games. Had a .232 batting average there. 16 hits, 8 runs. And didn't play at all in 2020. Ripped foul. Teammates with Cam Kondo there for a few seasons. But her most impressive season was that 2021 campaign where she appeared in 22. And certainly takes that California experience with her over here to Washington, D.C., the long trek across country. And this count works to full. 7-0 Georgetown. Bottom of the fifth inning. One run gives them the mercy rule here. Towson trying to at least extend the evening to the sixth. It comes home here. Ball four. So Zamora on for the first time tonight. And May Forshee is the DP. Now the batter. Singled, scored a run just one inning ago. Grad student from Phoenix, Arizona. Just continues to be a threat in her Georgetown career. And she's going to be one of those players who this program is going to be really sad to see go. From her contributions at the plate to her contributions behind the plate, she has done it all for this team. And even when things can look somewhat grim, she has been one of the bright spots of sunshine on this team. And when this team has been just improving ever more so with each step of this season, she has been right in the thick of it. And that one fouled off of her leg. Already this season, Georgetown with more conference wins than what they've had in just about 10 years. Haven't even appeared in the Big East postseason since 2014, where they lost first game to St. John's. That was back in the Guy Mason days. There's their home venue. This venue wasn't built up yet. There's a chance by Zamora, and she gets into second. It wasn't the cleanest of handles by Ferguson behind the plate, so Zamora says, I'll take that. And definitely didn't want to test it if you were Ferguson, especially with that being the game-ending run. And with the count 3-1, Forshee just needs a smart hit into center, and she can do the job. And this one, into the outfield, it is fair. Rounding third, heading home, Zamora, and this game is over. RBI double for Forshee. It sends home Zamora, and just that one simple bobble did it all. And Georgetown picking up their 14th win of the season, an 8-0 shutout of the Towson Tigers, just their fifth shutout of the season. But folks, let us not look away from the extremely prominent and impressive pitching by Kayla Dunn tonight. This is a Towson lineup, folks, who is powerful, they are fast, they find hits every step of the way, and just could not do so tonight. The only hit was a hit that didn't even leave the infield. Mackenzie Lake got on. That was it. Kayla Dunn pitching a gem, tallying what was her second best tally of strikeouts this season at 8, which tied herself up with the complete game she threw against Providence on the 5th of April. Still behind her career high of 10 Ks against Villanova when they came to town, but that was the game of Kayla Dunn. If you were to give a player the game, it has to be her. 3 for 3, including a couple singles, a double and an RBI, and a run scored. And as we mentioned, only allowing one hit from the pitching end of things. So Towson, who were rolling coming into this game, facing a pitcher who was on it tonight, and they will need to reset before heading forward with their play, as they don't go too far. They just go to Newark, Delaware, to play those Fighting Blue Hens up there, who are also top of the Colonial. That's going to be a fun weekend, that's for sure. But for Georgetown, we mentioned already, they go on the road, and they won't be home again until the last series of the season. They won't be home again until May, when DePaul come to town, but folks, this is a team who is just on the cusp of a potential postseason berth. They got to get some victories. You'll be able to tune in, of course. St. John's will be hosting those streams. That's their next weekend series before George Mason welcomes them, and then Butler before they're back home to close off the season here at the Washington Nationals Youth Baseball Academy. Folks, if you can, the game is still going on. If you want to stay here on Hoya Vision but go elsewhere, the baseball game's still going on right now. It's 19-1 for Georgetown against Mount St. Mary's right now. But as for this one, just catty-cornered field away, it is a final score of Georgetown 8, Towson 0. We will see you next time, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your night. I'm Christian Taylor, our cameraman, Mr. Raph Swanis, running everything tonight. Enjoy the rest of your evening.